It's been 5 years since Zach Sobiech passed away from a rare form of bone cancer called osteosarcoma. But the Lakeland teenager who composed and recorded Clouds continues to build a legacy. As we first showed you last night, research sponsored by Zach's fund has now led to a clinical trial of a drug that may target one of the genes causing osteosarcoma. It is a development that gives Zach's mother hope.
For us, it was the anthem of a teenager who inspired. For a mother, it was the hymn that soared along with her son.
And Clouds just keeps going out there in the universe.
It just does. It'll be 5 years this May. And I still cannot wrap my head around any of this. And I'm okay with that. You know, I don't have to understand it all.
What Laura Sobiech does understand, every download and dollar donated has grown the Zach Sobiech Osteosarcoma Fund. Now over $1.5 million, each of them earmarked for research. Laura and her husband Rob first met with researchers at the U of M in 2013, weeks after Zach died.
And we came from two different perspectives. I really wanted to understand why. Like, why did this happen? Genetically, what happens with osteosarcoma? Because I just felt like if we could figure that out, then we could learn how to treat it better. But Rob was really wanting to have new therapies now for kids who were diagnosed today.
5 years later, researchers in this lab are seeing real results. Doctors from different fields are working together. They've started an osteosarcoma registry, and they've launched a promising new immunotherapy trial.
They've been able to isolate some genes, some genetic markers in osteosarcoma that have not yet been identified. And one of those genes, those genetic markers, SEMA4D, there's an existing drug out there for adults for a different cancer that we think might actually work with some of these kids who have this marker.
Children now taking a drug that doctors believe may target osteosarcoma, all part of a 3-year trial that takes this mother back to her own days beside her son.
One of those days, we were sharing a room with a 9-year-old who had osteosarcoma, and it was during that stay that Zach said, "Mom, if I had to die so that little guy could have his childhood back, I would do it." And I can't help but think with this new phase one trial that that wish might come true.
A wish becoming a legacy, lifting Zach's family a little higher.
We are incredibly blessed to be in a place where we can see how his suffering and death has played out for the good. And I think that's not something that everybody gets, but we did, and so I recognize that as a blessing.
Amazing family, right?
You have followed them since Zach got sick, mm-hmm. You know, since we all learned who they are. Tell me, what's the difference that you see in Laura today in the work she's doing? That she's mm-hmm. really able, how is she able to still do this?
I think she actually answered that directly, Jana, in saying that she finds such purpose that it's very comforting, frankly, to honor Zach and to continue this mission of helping other people. And like she said, he wanted to help other children. He wanted to give them their childhood back, despite the fact that he also was a child. Mm-hmm. He had that kind of wisdom. He was an old soul, she often says. And so I see she also mentioned she's there as a family getting back to a new normal. They're developing that. They're still grief stricken, but they're finally reaching that point. And this fund and what it's doing certainly helps them with that. There is, I should mention, a link on our website as well for that fund too.
Yeah, it's almost, and perhaps this is not the best way to say it, but a positive way of grieving in your grief too, that
Absolutely.
You're moving forward and doing something. And I know you have that in your journey to fight Alzheimer's and things that we take up as causes. It's so important to channel that energy into something for change.
That's so true. Thank you for thinking of that, making that connection.
Yeah, it's very true. We'll be right back.